It's nice to have Kelly back in studio, socially distanced, of course, but she's here because we've had some severe weather roll through. I can tell you, Kelly, driving to work today, it was blinding on I-65 for a little bit.
Yes, I almost hydroplaned on I-465. It was bad.
It was.
But, and we're still dealing with some severe thunderstorm warnings out there. Here is some rain in Fishers earlier this afternoon. My goodness, it was just coming down in buckets. We had a lot of lightning. I know I heard it before I even came down here earlier this afternoon, so it was just pretty brutal. But now let's take a look at our live Doppler 13 radar. It is still blowing up with a lot of strong storms. We still have this storm that is pushing off to the northeast, impacting Jennings County and Jackson County. Now, the one to the north of there, Bartholomew and Decatur County, that one has been allowed to be canceled. But this one's still packing in a punch. Large hail and some gusty winds. As you can see, we still have a tornado watch to our north. It does include Benton counties, and the warning that was in Illinois, that has now expired as well. So we're getting into a better phase at this point, but we were concerned that we could see some of those tornado warnings popping up in northwest central Indiana. We still have a lot of heat in some spots, 83 degrees in Lafayette, but down to 73 in Indianapolis. It's 66 where it's just been rain cooled in Columbus. Now, we still have the severe outlook, but most of the storms now are really going to start dying down once this last batch moves off to the east, and we'll be in better shape the rest of the evening, especially once we hit 9 p.m. The models have not been doing a great job. We're not out of the question that we could still see a couple of thunderstorms popping up, but most of that will not be severe at all, maybe just some heavy downpours. All of this calms down, and then we'll be in a quieter overnight. And temperatures will start to fall into those low 70s throughout the evening hours with still an isolated shower storm possible. Now, as we get into tomorrow, we're going to be watching out for an isolated thunderstorm, but we shouldn't see as much as we saw today. But we're going to see some hot and humid temperatures. They'll be climbing into the upper 80s. Heat indices will make it feel like it's in the low 90s with a breeze out of the southwest as those temperatures climb into the mid to upper 80s tomorrow afternoon. Now, as we get into Monday, Memorial Day, I think we are going to see more showers and thunderstorms pushing into the area, and will also be another hot day. We'll see those temperatures soaring back into those upper 80s. So here's a look at your 7-day forecast. We'll get up to 86 degrees for tomorrow. Memorial Day, warm and humid, isolated thunderstorms possible both Sunday and Monday. As we get into Tuesday, we have spotty showers, and then it looks to be a bit more scattered in nature. We're still warm, though, as we continue through a good chunk of the week. We're in those mid-80s. And then storms likely are on Friday morning. As we get into Saturday, we cool off to around 80 degrees. Not too bad, Jenny.
Not bad at all. All right, Kelly, thank you.